نسألك العفو والعافية في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. اللهم يا ربنا أصلح لنا شأننا كله وأصلح عاقبتنا في الأمور كلها. دبر لنا فإننا لا نحسن التدبير، وقدر لنا فإننا لا نحسن التقدير. اللهم يا ربنا يا ربنا إنا نسألك بأسمائك الحسنى وصفاتك العليا أن تفك عنا ما نزل بنا من البلاء العظيم. اللهم يا ربنا فك عنا البلاء والوباء، اللهم فك عنا البلاء والوباء، واكتبنا من أهل القبول، واكتبنا من أهل القبول، واهدنا إليك صراطا مستقيما. اللهم يا ربنا اجعلنا من كل يا ربنا اجعلنا من كل ضيق مخرجا ومن كل هم فرجا، واجعل لنا من بعد العسر يسرا. اللهم يا ربنا بارك لنا في شعبان وبلغنا رمضان، اللهم بارك لنا في شعبان وبلغنا رمضان، اللهم ارزقنا صيامه وقيامه على الوجه الذي يرضيك عنا، واكتبنا فيه من عتقائك من النار. آمين آمين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. أما بعد, our dearly beloved community, I'm coming to you to share another one of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's attributes in our series, Know Your Creator. And we've started this series with the intention of growing in our relationship with Allah Azza wa Jal in these days in which we feel physical isolation. Hopefully we can feel strong connection with Him and with those around us and with the community as a whole through these alternative means of communication. Now, the attributes that I want to discuss with you this week all relate to each other. And the three are Al-Hakeem and Al-Aleem and Al-Aziz. These three attributes of Allah Azza wa Jalla are often mentioned together in the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, La ilaha illa huwa al-Aziz wal-Hakeem. Wallahu alimun hakeem. And in a less common place in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Wa kana Allahu wasi'an hakeema. Allah's hikmah, His wisdom, and Allah's knowledge, His ilm, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is izzah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as attribute al-aziz. We'll come to describe all three. Today I want to go over the attributes of hikmah, al-hakim. Now, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions hikmah, wisdom in the Quran, He mentions it as a divine gift. And they're mentioned in two different locations. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when it relates to human beings, He says, وَمَنْ يُؤْتَ الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوْتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. Whoever is given wisdom has given an abundance of goodness. It's such a beautiful divine gift. And just before mentioning Luqman al-Hakim's advice to his son, he says, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةَ أَنْ اشْكُرْ لِلَّهِ. It's a cause for reflection here. Why is it that when Allah Azza wa Jal mentions hikmah and wisdom, He mentions it as a divine gift? That shows you how special an attribute it is for the believer and how magnificent it is an attribute for Allah Azza wa Jal. Our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam tells us that this attribute is something worth envying another over. The Prophet ﷺ is reported to have said, لا حسد إلا في اثنتين رجل آتاه الله مالا فسلطه على هلكته في الحق وآخر آتاه الله حكمة فهو يقضي بها ويعلمها. Prophet ﷺ said, there is no situation that warrants envy. And of course, this is talking about ghibta, a good, positive sense of envy. Wanting what another has been given without wanting that to be stripped from them. Prophet ﷺ said there should be no sense of envy except for two things. An individual who's been given an abundance of material wealth and possessions, and he used that material wealth in truth and for the sake of truth and for good causes. As our Prophet ﷺ says, نِعْمَ الْمَالِ الصَّالِحِ لِلرَّجُلِ الصَّالِحِ. Blessed is the pleasant wealth for the righteous man or for the righteous woman. وَآخَرُ آتَاهُ اللَّهُ حِكْمَةً. And another whom Allah has given wisdom, and He judges by it among people, and He teaches it to others. Brothers and sisters, before going over Allah's attribute, Al-Hakim, it's important for us to reflect on the definition of hikmah in Arabic language. Now, they mention several different meanings, the first of which is relating to perfection. Now, they say Al-Hakeem is siga, sigatu mubalagha. It's a form of emphasis in Arabic language. Hakim ala wazni fa'il bima'na fa'il, meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Hakim is the one who perfects all that he has, who has perfected all that he has created. Ahkam as-san'a idha atqanaha. In Arabic language, when they say ahkam as-san'a, they mean that he perfected the trade. Idha atqanaha, meaning he perfected it to the best possible level of performance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses hikmah, or he describes his hikmah in many verses of the Quran in the sense of perfection. One of these verses is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِي خَلَقَ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ طِبَاقًا مَا تَرَى فِي خَلْقِ الرَّحْمَنِ مِنْ تَفَاوُتٍ فَرْجِعِ الْبَصَرَ هَلْ تَرَى مِنْ فُطُورٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِي خَلَقَ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ طِبَاقًا, the one who created seven heavens in layers. مَا تَرَى فِي خَلْقِ الرَّحْمَانِ مِنْ تَفَاوَتٍ, you do not see in the creation of Ar-Rahman any discrepancy. This is because of the perfection of his creation. In another verse, he says, subhanahu, صُنْعَ اللَّهِ الَّذِي أَتْقَنَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ إِنَّهُ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَفْعَلُونَ. This is the creation and the doing of Allah Azza wa Jal, the one who perfected all things. Indeed, he's acquainted with all that you do. So this is the first meaning of hikmah. يعني أحكم الشيء, meaning he perfected it. And another meaning of hikmah is full control. They say, فلان أحكم قبضته على هذا المشروع أي سيطر عليه. The individual has full authority and sovereignty over a certain project or a certain task. They say that they refer to this as أَحْكَمَ قَبْضَتَهُ عَلَى هَذَا. That means he has full control over it. And among the usages in Arabic language, they say is حَكَمَةُ اللِّجَامِ. This is referring to a certain, it's referring to the bit in the horse's mouth. You have a bit and a bridle and you have the reins. So the bridle is the thing that's placed on the head of the horse to steer it. And the bit is the metal or the iron that holds the bridle together. And then you have the reins. So they say, حَكَمَةُ اللِّجَامِ وَقِطَعَةٌ مِنَ الْحَدِيدِ تُوضَعُ فِي فَمِ الْفَرَسِ. So hikmah refers to full control as well. It also refers to awareness of minute details. As they say, Allah is al-hakim, يعني المدرك لدقائق الأمور. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is aware of all of the minute details in existence. And in this case, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكُلُّ شَيْءٍ عِنْدَهُ بِمِقْدَارِ عَالِمُ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ الْكَبِيرُ الْمُتَعَالِ. Nothing in Allah's creation lacks purpose. Nothing that Allah allows you to, causes you to experience in life lacks any purpose. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very calculated, very deliberate. He never overlooks a thing. And this is all coming from the attribute Al-Hakim. وَكُلُّ شَيْءٍ عِنْدَهُ بِمِقْدَارِ. Everything in by Allah Azza wa Jal is in due proportion. As in another verse, and this one many of us have memorized, Surah Al-A'la, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِي خَلَقَ فَسَوَّى وَالَّذِي قَدَّرَ فَهَدَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who created and then he proportioned. The one who proportioned and then guided. So this meaning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's attribute Al-Hakim is meaning that he's aware of the minute details of existence. And there's two beautiful lines of poetry that emphasize this. فَابْدَأْ بِنَفْسِكَ ثُمَّ انْتَقِلِي إِلَى الْعَالَمِ الْعُلْوِيِّ ثُمَّ السُّفْلِي تَجِدْ بِهِ صُنْعًا بَدِيعَ الْحِكَمِ لَكِنْ قَامَ لِيلُ الْعَدَمِ. The poet is saying, look within yourself, within your creation and your being, and then go to this universe of Allah Azza wa Jal. Look in the heavens above, and then look around you as well. You will find in it a creation that is full of wisdom, full of the wisdom of the divine, indicative that it came from Adam and existence, whereas Allah Azza wa Jal, his existence is not contingent upon anything else. Hikmah. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that our father Ibrahim and Ismail prayed that Allah send a messenger that will teach hikmah. رَبَّنَا وَابْعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. Oh Allah, send among them a messenger that will recite to them your verses and teach them the book and the wisdom. If you go to the statements of the scholars, you'll find that the majority of them say that what's meant by hikmah here is the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. Now that's cause for reflection. The sunnah being the hikmah, the wisdom. And the sunnah is known to be the application of the Quran, the explanation of the Quran, meaning that wisdom relates to knowing how to apply what needs to be applied. And this brings us to the exact definition of what wisdom is. They say, al-hikmatu fi'lu ma yanbaghi ala al-wajhi alladhi yanbaghi fi al-waqti alladhi yanbaghi. Hikmah, wisdom, the essence of wisdom is knowing or is doing what ought to be done, the way it should be done, at the time it should be done. So wisdom is something more than just knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala links knowledge and wisdom together, but knowledge is a stepping stone to wisdom. Knowledge is not wisdom is not limited to knowledge of information. No, it's something beyond that. But it's madhinnatul hikmah, as our scholars, they say. And that's why Sayyidina Luqman is reported to have instructed and advised his son. He said to him the following, Ya bunay, جالس العلماء وزاحمهم بركبتيك فإن الله يحيي القلوب بنور الحكمة كما يحيي الله الأرض الميتة بوابل السماء. He says that Sayyidina Luqman, when he advised his son, he said, O my son, sit close to those of awareness and knowledge. يا بني جالس العلماء وزاحمهم وبركبتيك. Sit closely to them. Listen attentively. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحْيِي الْقُلُوبَ بِنُورِ الْحِكْمَةِ. Allah brings light to the heart with the light and radiance of wisdom, as Allah brings life to the earth with the heaven, with the rain descending from the heavens above. So when it comes to knowledge and wisdom, it's very important to note that our deen recognizes the significance of experiential knowledge. Al-ilm al-tajribi, experiential knowledge. And what I mean by that is, knowledge is not just in textbooks. When we're talking about knowledge and awareness, we don't mean information. We mean experience in life, understanding different situations and how they relate to yourself and your relationship with Allah Azza wa Jal. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about patience in the Quran, وَكَيْفَ تَصْبِرُ عَلَى مَا لَمْ تُحِطْ بِهِ خُبْرًا. How on earth can you be patient with something you're not acquainted with? Meaning that patience is a virtue that comes through experience. And the same thing with gratitude. It's a virtue that comes with experiential knowledge. حتى إذا بلغ أشده وبلغ 40 سنة قال ربي أوزعني أن أشكر. When he reached the age of 40 and he reached the climax of his physical and mental growth, he recognized the need for gratitude. So you see, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةَ أَنْ يَشْكُرْ لِلَّهِ. We've given wisdom to Luqman to recognize the significance of experiential knowledge and the products of experiential knowledge, like patience and gratitude. Brothers and sisters, there are so many ways that we can live this attribute of Allah Azza wa Jal in our lives. This is one of the fundamental attributes of Allah Azza wa Jal. It plays into how we understand everything that plays out in our lives, everything that happens to us. It's important to recognize that it's happening with divine wisdom, that nothing in existence is ever detached or disconnected from divine wisdom. It's all connected to Allah Azza wa Jalla's wisdom. But how to live this attribute in our lives? The first reflect and note is part of hikmah is knowing how to cause people to love Allah Azza wa Jal, especially those around you. And there's a beautiful statement by Sayyidina Abu Darda in which he says, لَإِنْ شِئْتُمْ لَأُقْسِمَنَّ لَكُمْ إِنَّ أَحَبَّ عِبَادِ اللَّهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ الَّذِينَ يُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ وَيُحَبِّبُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَى خَلْقِهِ. Sayyidina Abu Darda, one of the companions of our Prophet ﷺ, he said, if you wish, I will take an oath by this statement, indeed the most beloved to Allah are the ones who love Allah, and the ones who cause others to love Allah Azza wa Jal. Living this attribute, causing others, especially those around you, especially your family members, to love Allah Azza wa Jal. It needs a lot of wisdom, knowing how to allow that love of Allah and how to allow faith to penetrate the hearts. That comes by wisdom and it comes by sincerity. And for this reason, Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was commanded in the Quran to give da'wah on the basis of wisdom. He says, "Ud'u ila sabili rabbika bil hikmati wal maw'izati al hasana." Invite to the path of your Lord with wisdom and with good advice. So it needs wisdom and it needs sincerity to have the care for how others receive your message, your words. Awareness is another thing to reflect on when it comes to living this attribute. First, as we said, understanding things that happen in our life and their relation to divine wisdom. Second, causing others to love Allah. Third, in the way we invite others to the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. And fourth, in our focus on developing our experience, our awareness in life through the experiences we have and through the knowledge that we seek. And that's why tomorrow we'll be speaking about Al-Aleem, the all-knowing. Awareness, as the Prophet ﷺ said, "May yurid Allahu bihi khayran yufaqihhu fi al-deen." Whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants goodness for, he'll give him a depth of understanding in the religion. This brings me to the fifth point. How can we live Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's attribute? Al-Hakeem, the all-wise and the all-knowing. They say that the essence of one of the sciences of Arabic language, which is known as balagha, in English we call it rhetoric. They say that the essence of rhetoric is to know how to say something in a way that penetrates the heart. And for this reason, they used to describe poetry in ancient Arabia as a form of magic. And this is actually attributed to the Prophet ﷺ, in which he said, "Inna min al-bayani lasihra." There is a form of expression that does magic. And that's what balagha is. Knowing how to say something in a way that is received so well by the other side. This is part and parcel of wisdom. Beautifying your speech. If we're able to do this, we'll be strong head on the way of winning over the hearts of people and changing them for the better and changing ourselves also for the better. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Hakeem, to bless us to witness His hikmah and His wisdom in everything in existence. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the gift of wisdom and to make us of those who cause others to love Him and to make us of those who beautify their speech and to those who endeavor self-awareness and awareness of their reality. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us with beneficial knowledge and guidance. Allahumma ameen, Allahumma ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.